How's it going, everyone? My name is Logan Kilpatrick. I'm the developer community advocate for the Julia programming language. Really excited to talk today about how folks can get involved with the Julia organization as part of Google Summer of Code. For folks who don't know what Julia is, it's a high-level dynamic programming language with speed characteristics similar to a language like C++, but per sort of usability and syntax that's actually quite similar to a language like Python. Julia has been involved in Google Summer of Code for 2023, will hopefully be our 10th year, which is really exciting. So we're deeply involved. We've had tons and tons of students sort of trickle through the program, students who actually, students and now contributors more broadly, who have gone from being, you know, a contributor to a mentor and now are sort of running, you know, massive open source projects within the Julia ecosystem, which has been awesome to see. So tons of success in that sense. Which we love and appreciate. But for folks who aren't familiar with Julia and this sort of technical problem that it solves, it really was sort of created to solve the quote unquote two language problem, which is as you sort of take a really computationally intensive task into production, oftentimes you have to use a different programming language to actually do that than the one that you originally wrote the program in. So you would go from something like Python to C++, for example. And Julia really sort of closes the gap between these two languages and allows you to do your prototyping and your production code development in a single programming language. And we have projects sort of spanning, you know, a massive breadth across the ecosystem. We have things from, you know, web development to game development to all the way, you know, all of the scientific domains from machine learning to scientific machine learning. And that's really sort of the sweet spot where you see a lot of Julia projects thriving is in the scientific tooling ecosystem. So the scientific machine learning ecosystem is probably the biggest place. So if that's an area of interest for folks, the Julia organization has tons of available projects in that sense. As far as contributors, what we're really looking for is folks who have actually tried out Julia before and have a little bit of experience at least with the language. And the only reason for that is, again, you know, it can be really difficult to have sort of a dual learning curve as far as getting up to speed on open source, getting up to speed on a specific project and code base, and trying to learn Julia at the same time. I think it just becomes, you know, a huge hassle. So the most successful contributors we've seen over the years have been folks that have dabbled with Julia a little bit, maybe made a few small contributions across the ecosystem, and then came into Google Summer of Code and were really able to excel. So we have tons of resources available on our website, julialang.org. There's a JSOC tab in the top right-hand corner, which sort of has all of our contribution programs and specifically a section for Google Summer of Code. So if you want to learn more about expectation, hear from some of our past contributors, all that kind of stuff, I'll refer you to the Julia Lang website, and hopefully we'll hear back from you and get you involved in the ecosystem. And thanks for watching, and we'll see you in Google Summer of Code.